Yes, of course, there are limits to any field of explanation. The reason that there are limits is because I honestly believe, and I think it's a good part of human belief, that there are mysteries which exceed human explanation of any kind. But let's limit ourselves to science. Science seeks natural explanations for natural events. Now, we could spend a lot of time talking about what we mean by nature, but certainly there are experiences that go beyond nature. And let me give one example. Love. Love in human affairs and love in religious affairs. So the love of husband for wife and wife for husband, the love of parents for children, the growing love of two young people who intend to really promise themselves to one another in marriage. If that's true love, then there are visible signs of that love that we can see. There are natural events that show that love. But the love itself is beyond science to explain, because it's interior. There's an interiority of not just the human being, there's an interiority to nature which it cannot be explained by science, is beyond scientific explanation. And consequently, the best of both science and the totality of human experiences is not to exclude any of these experiences. I would call them experiences rather than explanations, because that leaves us open to things like love. It leaves us open to God's dealing with us. If I believe there is a God, then God is not just a God of explanation or a God of need. God is a God of love. So, yes, there are those limits to scientific research.